gentlemen, our next match is for one fall with a 10-minute time limit. Introducing first from Edina, Minnesota, he weighs in at 247 pounds, Steve Olsonoski. And now, making his way into the ring area, the AWA International Television Champion from Mound, Minnesota, at 218 pounds, Greg Gagne.
They so oft-time used the terms a classic. And this should be a classic between that young man, Greg Gagne, and Steve Olsonoski. And very quickly, Vern Gagne, your thoughts on this one as the bell rings.
Well, this should be quite a scientific match. At least I hope it is. I hope both boys resort to that and don't worry about anybody else in the whole stadium, in the whole arena here, and concentrate on their wrestling abilities, because they both have great wrestling ability.
Greg Gagne, the International Television Champion. These two young men have grown up in the Twin Cities area of Minneapolis and St. Paul and have known each other for some time and have actually worked out together on more than one occasion. And there's a hamstring move by Greg Gagne on Steve Olsonoski. But all friendship or anything along that line goes out the window once you step into the squared ring together and one man going for what the other man has. And in this particular instance, the championship, the television championship belt owned by Greg Gagne.
Well, good move there by Steve Olsonoski. Greg kicking it out and ready for him. And you've got to be. Both these men, our young men, are very quick and fast. Reminds me of the great wrestler out of Manchester, England, Billy Robinson, the great Billy Robinson, who I think was England's greatest wrestler. I think there may be some people listening to me right now in England who are saying, no, I don't think Billy was. But in my book, of all the people I've met around the world over the years, Billy Robinson was one of the top wrestlers that I've ever met. And you people in Manchester, England, can be very proud of him.
The action, fast and furious. Whoop. Here from the Showboat. Oh, hey, nice move by Steve Olsonoski.
That was a terrific drop toe hold by Steve, but his momentum carried him right on through it, and he lost it. But that's a very devastating hold, and I haven't seen that in years.
Oh, no, I was going to say the same thing. You just don't see that happen in a ring these days. But it doesn't mean that one isn't going full out and as hard as he can to beat the other. And here's a full Nelson by Steve Olsonoski. Great camera close-up work here from the Showboat Sports Pavilion. As always, Rick Tucker.
That big full Nelson there by Steve Olsonoski. Got that leverage. Come on, Greg. It's always hard sitting here watching your son
right
participate
you
in a match. But good move.
And a reversal. Once in a while, you will see a man submit from a full Nelson. Not all of that often, but I have seen it happen, and a nice reversal here by Steve-O. And Greg trying to duck his way out of it. He does, and comes out with a hammerlock.
Now the sit down and the turn in there, and right back in there with that hammerlock. These young guys are both very fast for their weight and size. Greg should have the advantage in speed a little bit. And of course, Steve-O has got the advantage in the weight area. 240 pounds.
Yep. About a 30-pound weight advantage.
I got to congratulate again my good friend out of the University of Iowa, Dan Gable, the great season that he's had. Also, his former assistant, Jay Robbins, University of Minnesota, on a great season of amateur wrestling up there.
We're at the Showboat Sports Pavilion in Las Vegas, Nevada. I'm Rod Trongard, along with the former heavyweight champion of the world, Vern Gagne, in this television championship match between Greg Gagne, who holds the television championship belt. He won it following a series of matches, which resulted in points being awarded. And Greg Gagne was the winner of that tournament, and he has successfully defended that championship belt on more than one occasion. And I know he doesn't want to give up that belt, Vern, But if indeed he would have to, I don't think he would mind giving it up if he could get another one in return, like the championship belt currently worn by Curt Hennig.
Well, of course, that's the big thing that he's after, and the animosity between these two young guys, and myself and the old famous Larry the Axe. Hard block there by Greg into Steve, but Steve coming up fast. Greg going for a leg dive there, missed it. Steve, good bounce. Was not taken down. He hit him hard in that leg. Maybe Steve went with a Charlie horse in that left leg. That shoulder drove in there very, very hard.
And we see across the way Herbie Mills of the Mills Brothers. He is here at every wrestling match that they have at the Showboat Sports Pavilion, and he is enjoying the action here. You can't help but enjoy it. You don't see this all that often. And it is Steve-O kicking out on Greg Gagne. This is one fall. It is 10 minutes for the International Television Championship. Scott Ledoux is your third man in.
Well, at least some of the fans, I mean, a lot of the fans here tonight are enjoying this clean, scientific wrestling match, which so many of us love to see and love to see the participants do, and that's wrestling. Oh, a beautiful dropkick.
They're getting a chance to see that very, very thing. Some damage, it looks like, to the back of Steve Olsonoski as he was cartwheeled out of the ring, actually went between the second and top rope, and looked like he caught himself in the small of the back on the edge of the apron as he was spinning out. That young man is enjoying what he is seeing.
You mentioned Herbie Mills. You know, Herbie Mills are the Mills Brothers, the famous Mills Brothers trio. They were just fabulous over the, I'd say, 100 years. But he liked to get in the ring himself and roll around with the wrestlers and train. And he was very good.
Yes, indeed. There you see him across the way. Maybe we can get a close-up of Herbie Mills here before this one is all over. Greg Gagne, the television champion. Steve Olsonoski. Couple of natives of the state of Minnesota. Greg out of Mound, Minnesota. Steve-O out of Edina. Couple of suburbs, not all that far apart. And the action again really warms up. Oh, Steve-O caught him with a shot under the chin as Greg was coming across. There you see Herbie Mills. Hey, nice to see you, young man. Yeah. What great songs that trio put out for so many, many years. Back to wrestling.
Oh, well, he's caught with that one. Greg, you walked right into that. See the side suit play. No, not yet. Oh, anticipated wrong.
Hooks the leg, and he got a two count out of it all. He being Steve-O, Steve Olsonoski, and he continues on, and he goes into the abdominal stretch here.
Come on, Greg, you're going to have to move. You can't sit there like that. Steve's got a power. He's a strong young man, very fine athlete. Knows where to put that balance, put that weight, and that strength that pulls on the vital area there and on Greg's shoulder. Pointing out to you, Rod, where all that pressure is here on the monitor. But Greg has got to come out there. He's got to get his weight around
it. A father talking about the predicament that his son is in right now. And if Larry Olsonoski was here, we could really have a conversation going. And Greg reverses it on Steve-O and almost got a pinfall here, and now with a hard shoulder block, it's Greg Gagne. Uh-oh. That knee into the solar plexus, and here comes Olsonoski again, but Greg rolls out of the way, and Olsonoski misses that elbow smash. We are in the final minute of this match from the Showboat Sports Pavilion in Las Vegas. Back and forth they go, and a hard, crunching collision in the center of that ring, and both men are paying the price, and Ledoux is in the count, and he's at three.
Well, you can hear that way back here.
Oh, you can feel it way back here.
30 seconds remaining in this match.
In the final 30 seconds, Olsonoski, the first to his feet, trying to finish off the television champion. An atomic drop here. And now Greg reverses and does the same thing to Steve Olsonoski. A quick cover here by Greg Gagne, getting only a count of one. as we enter the final 10 seconds of the match. A whip by Gagne, a reversal by Steve-O, and a reversal here by Greg Gagne, and a reversal again. And did he beat the bell? Apparently he did. You can't get any closer than that. Greg Gagne winning it.
No, Greg Gagne winning it.
Yes. Did I say Vern?
I think you did.
Well, Greg Gagne winning it with 1 second remaining in this match. 1 second remaining as Gagne gets the pinfall with a cradle or a rollover or a reversal, however you want to put it, on Steve Olsonoski. And yes, the crowd loved this scientific match between these two fine young men. And we'll take another look at how this thing came to an end. You see Greg forcing Steve Olsonoski to the ropes, then rolling him over and pinning those shoulders to the mat and getting the three count just ahead of the bell.
Steve was bent into that position. He could not. He finally kicked him off, but it was too late. Tremendous match. Proud of both guys.
Indeed, indeed. Steve waited just a fraction of a second too long to kick out, and the match lasted a fraction of a second.